In this video, we're going to go over the steps involved in meiosis. Meiosis is the process that occurs in reproductive cells that produces the gametes, the sperm, and the eggs. It is the process where a parent cell divides in such a way that forms four daughter cells that each have half the number of chromosomes that were present in the parent cell. Before meiosis occurs, the diploid parent cell goes through interphase, where the cell grows, the DNA is replicated, now leaving us with homologous pairs of replicated chromosomes, which each have two sister chromatids. During interphase, the cell also prepares for meiosis. There are two rounds of meiotic divisions involved in meiosis, meiosis 1 and meiosis 2. There are four phases in meiosis 1, prophase 1, metaphase 1, anaphase 1, and telophase 1. The first phase of meiosis 1 is prophase 1. During prophase 1, the DNA which is in chromatin form condenses into chromosomes through supercoiling of the DNA. This makes it visible under the microscope. These chromosomes are made of two identical sister chromatids that are joined in the middle at the centromere. The nuclear envelope, also known as the nuclear membrane, breaks down during prophase 1. During prophase 1, the paired centrosomes separate and move to poles on opposite side of the cell. These centromeres also start to form microtubule spindle fibers during this phase. Also in this phase, the chromosomes cluster and the homologous chromosomes pair up. The term used for a pair of homologous chromosomes is a bivalent. This is when crossing over occurs, where genetic material is exchanged between non-sister chromatids of these homologous pairs. Crossing over is important as it creates genetic diversity. The second phase of meiosis 1 is metaphase 1. During metaphase 1, the microtubule spindle fibers attach to the kinetochores. The kinetochore is a protein structure found at the centromere of a chromosome. The microtubule spindle fibers from one pole attach to the kinetochore of one of the pair of chromosomes, whilst fibers from the other pole attach to the other chromosome of the pair. The microtubule spindle fibers contract and pull at the kinetochores of different chromosomes, which cause the homologous pairs of chromosomes to align along the middle of the cell, along what is called the metaphase plate or equatorial plate. The third phase of meiosis 1 is anaphase 1. During anaphase 1, the spindle fibers continue to contract and cause one chromosome from each pair to move towards the opposite poles of the cell. It is important to note that the sister chromatids stay attached to their centromeres and move together. The fourth phase of meiosis 1 is telophase 1. During telophase 1, now that the homologous chromosome pairs are separated onto the opposite poles of the cell, the spindle fibers break down. During this phase, if the cell is undergoing rapid meiosis, the nuclear envelope does not reform, and the chromosomes do not decondense before going into meiosis 2. In other cases, the nuclear envelope reforms around each set of chromosomes, which re-separate the genetic material from the cytoplasm in the cells, and the chromosomes decondense. Another process known as cytokinesis occurs at the same time as the end of telophase 1. This is where division of the cytoplasm occurs, creating two daughter cells, each containing one set of the separated homologous chromosomes. This now takes us into the second round of meiotic division known as meiosis 2, where both the daughter cells created in meiosis 1 go through it. Before meiosis 2 occurs, there is interkinesis. There is no DNA replication during interkinesis, but the centrioles still need to duplicate and form the centrosomes. There are four phases in the process of meiosis 2, prophase 2, metaphase 2, anaphase 2, and telophase 2. The first phase of meiosis 2 is prophase 2. During this phase, if the chromosomes did condense and the nuclear envelope reformed in telophase, then the chromosomes condense and the nuclear envelope breaks down in each of the daughter cells produced in meiosis 1. The centrosomes separate and move to poles on the opposite sides of the cell. These centrosomes also begin to form microtubule spindle fibers during prophase 2. The second phase of meiosis 2 is metaphase 2. During metaphase 2, microtubule spindle fibers find and attach to the kinetochores of the chromosomes in each daughter cell. The spindle fibers from opposite poles attach to each sister chromatid of a single chromosome, causing single chromosomes to align along the middle of the cell along what is called the metaphase or equatorial plate. The third phase of meiosis 2 is anaphase 2. During anaphase 2, the spindle fibers in both daughter cells continue to contract and cause the sister chromatids of each chromosome to separate at the centromeres. The sister chromatids move to opposite poles of the cell. The fourth phase of meiosis 2 is telophase 2. During telophase 2, now that the sister chromatids are separated onto the opposite poles of the cell, the spindle fibers break down. During this phase, the nuclear envelope reforms around each set of chromosomes, which re-separate the genetic material from the cytoplasm of the cell. These chromosomes also decondense at this phase. Cytokinesis again occurs at the same time as the end of telophase 2. This is where division of the cytoplasm occurs in each cell, creating in total 4 haploid daughter cells that each contain half the number of chromosomes as the original parent cell entering meiosis. In animals, these haploid cells can mature into gametes, the sperm and the eggs. Thank you for watching. If you want to support this channel, please subscribe and check out more of my videos.